This is a high-level overview of Project 2010. We will discuss the ribbon, the quick access toolbar, how to customize the quick access toolbar and the ribbon, the backstage view, the status bar. We will demonstrate how to copy and paste the timeline and the project, and then we will create a high-level project summary task. So let's get started. First, let's open project. You can see that project is customized into tabs. You have your task tab, your resource tab, your project tab, your view tab, your add-ins tab, and your format tab. You can see that I have activated the Gantt chart view. So in the format tab, the Gantt chart tools are activated. Therefore, on the ribbon, all of the commands are for the Gantt chart. However, this area is called your timeline. Your timeline is a high-level overview of your complete project. If I activate the timeline by clicking into it, you can see my tab for format changes to timeline tools. And all the commands on this ribbon now is for the timeline view. Again, if I activate the Gantt chart, it goes back to Gantt chart tools and all the commands are different. We have just above the ribbon, the quick access toolbar. And if I click on the more button, we can customize this quick access toolbar just by clicking on any of the commands that you would like. So I'm going to click on Quick Print and the command shows up. I can click on the More button. I can show the Quick Access toolbar below the ribbon. And here it is right below the ribbon. The default is to show the Quick Access toolbar above the ribbon. I can also click on the More button and I can click on the command More Commands. Once I go to More Commands, I can click on Customize the Ribbon. If I wanted to add a new tab to the ribbon, I can click on New Tab and click on Rename. And I can call this group anything I want. I choose to call it Denise. I'm clicking on Okay, and I want to put a command in my new group. So I'm going to put the Format Painter in my new group. I'm clicking on the Format Painter on my left side, where it says Popular Commands, or I can change this to All Commands and it will show me more commands. I want the Format Painter, so I'm clicking on that to activate the Format Painter, and I'm clicking on Add. So now the Format Painter is added to my new group and I'm going to say okay. And you can see a new tab shows up on the ribbon and it has the Format Painter and the group's name is Denise. Well, this is just to show you that you can customize the ribbon. I do not want that new tab. So I'm going to go back to my More button, click on the More Commands, and then I'm going to say okay, reset all customizations, because I want it to go back to the original customizations. And yes, I do want this, so I'm clicking yes and I'm clicking okay, and you can see that extra tab is now gone. Okay, we're in the Gantt chart view. While working in the Gantt chart view, if we clicked on this gray area and we right click and we go to the view bar, we can view even more commands. You have more commands to choose from. I personally don't like working with that view bar open, so I'm going to close it, deactivate it. All right, and I did that just by right clicking. Show you again, right click, view bar. It comes up, I'm right clicking again, and I'm taking that check mark off, and it goes away, deactivates, all right? We also, and I don't know that you can see this on the screen, but we do have, I'll talk about it anyway. We do have all the way to the right, we have our zoom in, we have our zoom slider, which we can zoom in and zoom out. We can see more or less of our project, okay? And over to the right, and I'm not sure that you can see this on the screen, there is a way for us to take the project from manually scheduled to auto schedule. You can also click on your task tab and go from manually scheduled command to the auto schedule command in your task group. All right, now let's just look at our backstage view. So we're going to click on file. That takes us to our backstage view. You can save as, you can open, you can close. And this info command is very important. You can see, if you look under the project information, you can have a start date of your project. So if I wanted to change the start date of my project to 3/16/2011, I would just type in the date, click out into the white area, and my project is now changed. I can go back to the task tab and you can see it's changed from 3/16/14 into 3/16/11. I'm going to go back to my backstage view and talk about the backstage for a minute. I can click on recent to view all of the recent projects that I've worked on so far. I could click on new, and if I wanted to open up a new project, I would just click on blank project and click on the command create. If I wanted to print, and it takes a few minutes for my computer to work, you can see I can preview whatever I'm going to print and just go ahead and print the entire project or parts of the project if I want. I can save and send, send it as an attachment. I can save the project as a file, or I can create a PDF and send this project on. And I have my options as well. Okay, this brings up the project options display box. I can click on schedule. And I want to, just to make sure that the week starts on a Sunday, which is the default. The fiscal year starts in January. The default start time for my project is 8 a.m. The default end time is 5 p.m. The hours per day are 8, and the hours a week are 40, and the days per month are 20. These are all defaults, and that's fine. But if you need to change these, you can go right ahead and change that information. I don't need to change anything in this area, so let me just click on cancel. And I'm going to go back to my backstage view. And I'm going to go over here where it says project information. I'm looking at my start date. You know that I changed the start time to 3/16/11. I'm going to change it back to 14. Okay, and I want the start date to start today, which is a Sunday. I don't have to populate the finish date, because in project you're either going to populate the start date or the finish date. I want this project to schedule from the start date, so I'm just putting in the start date. The current date is today, the status date is today, last modified is today. My calendar, if I click on this more button, I have three calendars in project: the 24-hour calendar, a night calendar, and a standard calendar. For this particular project, I'm going to keep the standard calendar. Later on, I will show you how to customize your calendar. My priority is going to be 500. Even though in project, you can prioritize your projects. Especially if you're working on multiple projects, you want to make sure that you prioritize your projects. The priority is from 1 to 1,000. So the higher the project priority, the more attention project will give to your constraints to your project. Okay. I want to go back. I'm sorry. What I want to do right now is, since I'm in the backstage view, what I want to do is click on this more button for the project information. I want to create a high level summary task so that I know at all times when I look at my project, how long this project will take. So I'm going to click on the Advanced Properties command. And in the Advanced Properties command, you can put your title in here. Now, when you put your title in this particular field, this title will show up on your project. And I'm going to click OK. You can put whoever the project manager is, if it's you or someone else, and fill out all the rest of this information. I'm going to click OK. Then I'm going to go to my Options command. I'm going to go to the Advanced command. And then I'm looking for, in the display options for this project, I'm looking for this command, Show Project Summary Task. I'm clicking on this. And I'm going to say OK at the bottom of the screen. And you see that my summary shows up. It tells me how long this project is, 130 days. It tells me when it starts and when it finishes. I can just view it very quickly and find out exactly what it is, the duration, the start, and the finish date. Okay. So now the stakeholders want to have a copy, a high-level copy of the timeline. So what I can do is give them a copy of my timeline just by activating the timeline. I'm clicking, right-clicking on the timeline. Then I'm copying the timeline command for presentation. I'm clicking on that. Then I'm going to open Word. Once I open Word, I'm going to my Home tab and I'm clicking paste, and you see my timeline is now in Word. I put in three enters because I'm gonna go back to my project, and I want to give my stakeholders a bird's eye view of this particular project. So I'm highlighting exactly what they asked me for, these particular tasks. I'm clicking in the area of the clipboard group, clicking on the more button, I'm going down copy picture. I'm going to click on for printer. And I'm clicking OK. I'm opening up my Word document and I'm clicking paste. And my project shows up. So now if I want to send this to my stakeholders so they can find out where my project is at a particular time, they have it. They usually want to only have a high level view of the project. In the next class, I will be showing you the first lesson. Thank you, subscribe, and have a great day. Bye-bye.